Thank you for joining with me. We are on section 4 of chapter 3, Sane Perception in A Course in Miracles, complete and annotated edition. This is day 54 and we are reading section 4 of chapter 3, Innocent Perception. I am following the Course Companions outline, and that's a group in Facebook. If you would like to look it up and join, please do. It's by Emily Bennington and Robert Perry, and it's Course Companions. Section 4, Day 54, Innocent Perception. We have repeatedly stated that the basic concepts referred to throughout this course are not matters of degree. Going down to footnote 46, text chapter 149, the miracle makes no distinction among degrees of misperception. Chapter 2, section 5, but the sonship itself is a perfect creation and perfection is not a matter of degree. Chapter 2, section 12, it is worth repeating that ultimately there is no compromise possible between everything and nothing. And again, chapter 2, section 12. Any statement which implies degrees of difference in negation is essentially meaningless. Certain fundamental concepts cannot be meaningfully understood in terms of coexisting polarities. It is impossible to conceive of light and darkness, or everything and nothing, as joint possibilities. They are all true or all false. It is absolutely essential that you understand completely that behavior is erratic until a firm commitment to one or the other is made. Yet a firm commitment to darkness or nothingness is impossible. Nobody has ever lived who has not experienced some light and some of everything. This has made everybody genuinely unable to deny truth totally, even if he deceives himself in this connection most of the time. That is why those who live largely in darkness and emptiness never find any lasting solace. Innocence is also not a partial attribute. It is not a real defense until it is total. When it is partial, it is characterized by the same erratic nature that holds for other two-edged defenses. The partially innocent are apt to be quite stupid at times. It is not until their innocence as a genuine viewpoint, which is universal in its application, that it becomes wisdom. Innocent or true perception means that you never misperceive and always see truly. More simply, this means that you never see what does not exist in reality. Whenever you lack confidence in what someone else will do, you are attesting to your belief that he is not in his right mind. This is hardly a miracle-based frame of reference. It also has the disastrous effect of denying, incorrect use of denial, the essentially creative power of the miracle. The miracle perceives everything as it is. If nothing but the truth exists, and this is really redundant in statement because what is not true cannot exist, right-minded seeing cannot see anything but perfection. We have said many times that only what God creates and what you create with the same will has any real existence. That's footnote 47, text chapter 123. You are capable of this kind of creation too, being the image and the likeness of your own creator. Anything else is only your own nightmare and does not exist. Only the creations of light are real. And then chapter 149, While the miscreation is necessarily believed in by its own maker, it does not exist at all at the level of true creation. The miscreations of the mind do not really exist. This, then, is all that the innocent can see. They do not suffer from the delusions of the separated ones. The way to correct all such delusions is to withdraw your faith from them and invest it only in what is true. To whatever extent you side with false perception in yourself or others, you are validating a basic misperception. 48. To side with false perception seems to mean to see the perceiver as defined by his false perception rather than by the perfection God created in him. You are siding, in other words, with the power of the false perception to dictate who the person is. You cannot validate the invalid. I would suggest you voluntarily give up all attempts to do so because they can only be frantic. They can be only frantic. If you are willing to validate what is true in everything you perceive, you will make it true for you. Remember that we said that truth overcomes all error, and that's footnote 49, chapter 135. Remember that error cannot really threaten truth, which always can withstand its assaults. Only the error is really vulnerable. And then chapter 3, section 3. The resurrection demonstrated that nothing can destroy truth. Good can withstand any form of evil because light abolishes all forms of darkness. This means that if you perceive truly, you are canceling out misperceptions in yourself and others simultaneously, because you see them as they were really created and can really create. You offer them your own validation of their truth. This is the real healing which the miracle actively engenders. The reason why this section is so short, despite its extreme importance, is because it is not symbolic. This means that it is not open to more than one interpretation. This means that it is unequivocal. It also explains the biblical quotation, "But this we know, that when he shall appear," or be perceived, "we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. And every man that hath this hope in him purifieth himself, even as he is pure." Footnote 50. 1 John 3:2-3. "But we know that when he shall appear, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. And every man that hath this hope in him purifieth himself even as he is pure." That's a quote from the Bible, obviously. Every man does have the hope that he can see correctly because the ability to do so is in him. Man's only hope is to see things as they are. And now we will read Emily Bennington's notes for Day 54, Section 4, Innocent Perception, Overview. If light and darkness are either all true or all false, then our behavior will be erratic until we commit to seeing the light innocence in ourselves and others. Reflections. This section is asking us to withdraw our faith in delusions and invest only in what is true. We are asked to give up any false perception and see pure innocence in everyone. This innocence, since it is of God, is all that exists in reality. Accordingly, When we perceive truly, we are offering real healing as the Course defines it. Have you seen examples of this principle, instances where seeing innocence in someone in spite of appearances has a healing effect? Please write down what comes to you. Innocent perception. Great section. Thank you for joining with me. I'm pretty sure we're on to section 55. Oh no, key passages. Don't want to miss those. Innocence is also not a partial attribute. It is not a real defense until it is total. The miracle perceives everything as it is, if nothing but the truth exists, and this is really redundant in statement, because what is not true cannot exist. Right-minded seeing cannot see anything but perfection. Man's only hope is to see things as they are. And I thank you again for joining with me on day 54. I love you.